this special lady, Rebecca Marino, joining us once again here on BT. Great to see you.
Yeah, really happy to be here.
Topical time for you, and Jody and I have been chatting this up this morning. Front page of the province, many people speculating about your choice to leave the game of tennis from your mouth. What was the reason?
Yeah, there's been a bit of a message taken away from what I'm trying to say. I just don't have the passion that I do anymore for the sport, and I'm being quite honest with myself and just thinking it's time to pull away.
Well, clearly to be an elite athlete to the level that you're playing at, passion is key, because it is all-consuming. People don't understand, right? Yeah. The grass is not always greener. It's not as glamorous as you might think.
No, it's definitely not as glamorous. I mean, your whole day is consumed by your sport. The way you sleep, the way you eat, every single little action you do affects you. So, I'm just kind of growing a little tired of that and want to move on to a next chapter.
One of the quotes that stands out from the press conference yesterday, and guys, you can bring up this board. I mean, you have to make a decision like this. This has been a part of your life. This is one of the most difficult decisions, but also one of the best things you've ever done. At the age of 22, you've accomplished a lot. Where's your head at now? Where are you thinking is going to be the next step?
To be honest, I don't really have much of an idea as to what I want to do. I'm only a couple days into this, but I think I'll probably attend school. I'll try and look for a job. So if anyone has ideas for me, please holler at your girl.
Holler at your Vancouver girl who wants to get in. And in the break, we were talking about school. I was like, well, which school are you thinking? She's like, at UBC, and I've missed admissions, so call me.
Show
but
some love.
We're so proud of you. It's lost on many just how young you are, mm-hmm. 22 years old. And you were speaking about how being affected by depression for the last 6 years. So that's a very formative time and a difficult time to step forward. How did you deal with that?
It was quite difficult. Probably starting from the age of 16 or 17, I always had these sort of blue days, down days, gray days, as I call them. And I didn't think much of it until the last couple of years, where I had some of my coaches and my people around me, my support group, they told me that maybe I should seek help. And so I sought help, and I'm feeling much better about it, and I just want to share the message with everyone that it's okay to get help, it's okay to talk about depression.
And that's why we want to put this quote up, just in case anybody's watching with the sound down. This is also from yesterday. Seeking help got me through to a better outlook and made me enjoy life. What was the first step in seeking help? Did you talk to your parents? Did you talk to your doctor? Like, where did you go first?
Well, the first thing was one of my coaches before this, Simon LaRose, noticed that I was struggling a lot with some mental things that he didn't think was in his profession to deal with personally. So he made me go see a therapist to get help. And it sort of progressed from there. And I told my parents, my friends, and my family, and all my coaches around me, and everyone's been really supportive, which is really, really good to see.
You know, it's fascinating not only to hear about the depression, but the aspect of being a pro athlete and what goes on being in the public eye. People want to champion your successes, and when things don't go the way you had hoped and, you know, the way they had hoped, some criticism can come in. How difficult has that been, not only for you, but for the athletes on the Canadian circuit that you've worked with and played with, of dealing with that sort of thing?
Yeah, well, it is really difficult to hear criticism, particularly through social media such as Twitter or Facebook, where you can be directly talk to from your fans, and there's a lot of positive, but with that comes negative as well. And depending on what's said, it can really strike you down. And I've had some things that have really hurt me, but it doesn't control me at all. And that's why I want to show that I'm strong and I'm better than this, and tell other people that they can be better than it. And it's just a matter of getting the word around that, you know, we can change things.
And probably a good idea to not Google yourself and look for the negatives.
Yeah, that's what I would probably tell people not to do.
Mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Because it's always out there.
Oh, yeah. If you look, you will find.
When you look at your time playing, and as we were mentioning, so young and you accomplished a lot of great things, what's one of your most memorable experiences on the court?
I'd probably say my opportunity against Venus Williams on Arthur Ashe was probably the greatest opportunity I've ever had. I had so many people support me after that. I had so many opportunities to come after that as well. And who would want to play on Arthur Ashe Stadium? It's like the biggest tennis stadium in the world.
Is there anything Venus said to you before or after that match that you take away with in terms of advice for being an athlete or just personally?
No particular advice that she told me, but saying that, you know, she knew what it was like to play herself was definitely a boost in my self-esteem as well.
Now let's stick with self-esteem here. When you went and spoke with the counselor and shared how you were feeling, the lack of the passion for the game and that you were feeling blue, what was the advice that struck most close to home for you that maybe our viewers could garner from?
It's okay to express yourself. It's okay to be sensitive. I think in our society we're told we have to suck it up and have a thick skin, and I just sort of want to in a way share that it's okay to be feeling these things and you can talk about it. Like, it's okay to be very open about these things so long as you trust the people that you're talking to.
Were you surprised that your family, friends and coaches all went, if you want to step away, you should step away?
A little bit, but it also sort of told me I was doing the right thing, and that's how I know I have the best people around me.
And how does it feel having put this announcement out yesterday?
Yeah, well, it's been a whirlwind. I mean, I've been doing a lot of press-related things right now and haven't really had much rest time, but I'm glad I'm just being able to spread my message.
So that message continues, and it also, we were talking about forwarding what's next for Rebecca, mm-hmm. not tennis star, but the woman.
Yeah.
Now, you've been playing tennis since you were?
Approximately 10 years old.
10 years old,
yeah.
So 12 of your 22 years.
Yeah.
And what did you dream of being when you were a little girl?
When I was really little, probably 5 or 6, I wanted to be a vet. And then but when I was going to go to university, I wanted to be an architect. And now I think I've kind of put those two aside, and I might go into business or I might go into the arts. I don't know.
Use the things that you've learned about.
I was saying during the break, I was just commenting on the outfits. I think Rebecca should consider something in fashion because you do not know the shoe talk.
Have you seen the shoes?
The break,
look
you
at
know
her
Jones,
shoes.
All about the shoes.
I loved it. Sat down, she goes, I know I need to bring the shoes when I come here. Yeah, you do. Thank you for joining us and being so candid.
Yeah.
We really appreciate
it. My pleasure. Thank you.
Come back anytime. Let us know what you're doing.
I'd love it.
All right. Keep the message going. It's a great one.
UBC, right?
Yeah, UBC.
Call her. Hey, we'll see you on campus.
Yeah.